The Democratic Republic of Congo, the least vaccinated country against COVID-19 in the world, is struggling to keep up with a fourth wave of infections that is pushing its limited healthcare system to the brink. Here's a full story.
At the St. Joseph COVID Treatment Center in Kinshasa, patients lie in ramshackle rooms breathing oxygen from old tanks. The clinic has 38 beds and all but one are occupied. In a backyard littered with medical equipment, tents are needed to cope with the overflow. The Democratic Republic of Congo is the least vaccinated country against COVID-19 in the world. Now, a fourth wave of the coronavirus threatens to put greater pressure on its limited health system than at any time during the pandemic. François Kajingulu is the head of St. Joseph.
We have experienced the three previous waves, and gradually we saw the cases increase. In the fourth wave, there are overnight jumps. On Monday, we had 5 to 6 cases, and on Saturday, you go straight to between 30 or 36 cases, so 6 times higher. So there is a very rapid rise in COVID-19 cases in this fourth wave.
The increase is part of an Africa-wide surge that saw weekly COVID cases spike 83% in mid-December, driven by the Delta and Omicron variants, although deaths remain low, the World Health Organization said. Congo registered 6,480 new cases in the week of December 13th, more than double the number hit during its previous record in June, WHO data show. The official infection tally in Congo, which has a young population and where few people get tested, is still low compared to many countries. But the low level of inoculation worries health officials, who say that unvaccinated populations increase the risk of new variants emerging. Fewer than 300,000 people out of a population of 90 million have received at least one dose, Reuters data indicate, lower than anywhere else. Hostile terrain, remote populations, and lack of resources have stunted vaccine rollouts. The recent surge in cases has pushed authorities to ramp up inoculations, and the weekly vaccination rate is at its highest yet. This tented vaccinodrome in capital Kinshasa is part of that effort, where some who received their shots said they were persuaded to do so because of the latest surge.
Before, we were in the dark about the consequences associated with this fourth wave of COVID-19. This is too strong, and COVID really exists, and to protect myself, I've come to get the vaccine.
Health workers at the center are vaccinating around 200 people per day, but that is still below its 300-person capacity.
Well, U.S. President Joe Biden vows to ease a shortage in COVID-19 tests as the Omicron variant takes hold in the country. Limited availability of testing had crimped holiday plans, resulting in a gloomy Christmas for thousands of Americans. Biden admits his administration has to do more, but he insists the U.S. is equipped to meet the latest surge in infections, even if some hospitals could be overrun by cases.
That's why we stockpiled and pre-positioned millions of gowns, gloves, masks, and ventilators. We're mobilizing an additional 1,000 military doctors and nurses and medics to help staff hospitals, because steps we have to be taken to increase the number of authorized tests. We're now able to purchase 500 million at-home rapid tests to be sent to the American people for free when they request it. And we're going to continue to use the Defense Production Act to produce as many tests as possible, providing access to free tests for folks who don't have insurance. But we have to do more. We have to do better. And we will.
Rising COVID infections among U.S. airline staff forced carriers to scrap 800 more flights on Monday, the fourth straight day of cancellations. Anthony Fauci, America's top infectious disease expert, is recommending that the federal government consider a vaccine mandate for domestic air travel.